We are here with the leader of the Four Horsemen, James J. Dillon, on NWA Pro Wrestling. And you said about Ole Anderson, you've washed your hands of him.
Well, you know, Tony, Ole Anderson was part of the most elite group in the history of professional wrestling at one time. And I'm referring to the Four Horsemen. And I don't know what happened at some point along the way. He got his priorities out of order. And even though Ole Anderson is probably one of the toughest men to ever put on a pair of wrestling tights, when he did get his priorities out of order, he made some serious mistakes. When he slapped me, that could possibly have been forgiven. But when he turned his face on his back on the Four Horsemen, that was unforgivable. Then he tried to divide us, and he confronted Arn Anderson first. And, well, I think a picture is worth a thousand words. If we take a look at this, I think you'll see just exactly what happened when he confronted Arn Anderson. And as you see right here, Arn Anderson makes his position crystal clear. There should be no doubt in anybody's mind, especially Ole Anderson right now, just how Arn Anderson feels. And like I say, the Horsemen are together. Right here, I'm jockeying for position, but Ole Anderson right here needs to be put in his place. And he needs to be taught a lesson for slapping me, number one on national television, for insulting Tully Blanchard, calling him an outsider. After all, he is the world television champion and also part of this same elite group. And right here, Ole Anderson is getting smacked right flat on his face with a dreaded gourd buster, the same hold that's defeated men all over this world. And I thought that any intelligent man right now here, even the stubborn Ole Anderson, would realize that he's fighting something that's bigger than he could ever imagine. And as Ole Anderson was laying right here on the canvas, I don't know what was going through his mind, but if he had any intelligence at all, I think he would have said to himself, I guess I was wrong. I guess I bit off more than I could chew. Maybe I should back off and realize that I've made the mistake of my life that I can never rectify. I have turned my back on the Four Horsemen. But Ole Anderson, did he do that? No, the stubborn pink-faced fool got off the canvas, dusted himself off, and instead of going back to his dressing room, made a beeline for the dressing room of the Four Horsemen. And then he went in to the quarters of the World Heavyweight Champion. That's right, Ric Flair, and walked right up to his face and confronted him. And, well, I want to share with you just exactly what happened.
You don't see the light.
Yeah.
You're the one that we're here about here.